Hello students, this video is the third part of the chapter, the 100 dresses part 1. Now in this video, I am going to continue the remaining part of the story. As for Maddie, this business of asking Venda every day how many dresses and how many hats and how many this and that she had was bothering her. Now the continuous asking of questions by Peggy to Venda, that how many dresses she is having at her house or in her cupboard, how many shoes, variety of shoes she has. So this questioning of Peggy to Wanda was very troubling for Maddie. She did not like all these such types of questions. Maddie was poor herself. She usually wore somebody's hand-me-down clothes. Now what is the meaning of hand-me-down clothes? Hand-me-down clothes means the clothes which are of some other person, but due to the shortage of the length of the cloth, or the person does not like that cloth, he or she does not wear that cloth, and then he or she gives that cloth to some other person. So Maddie was poor. She was also poor like Wanda, and she also used to wear others' clothes. Thanks goodness, she didn't live up on Boggy's heights or have a funny name. But the difference between Wanda and Maggie was that Wanda used to live in an area which was surrounded by poor people like herself, while Maddie did not live in that particular area. And second thing, the name of Maddie was also not very funny like that of Wanda. So because of these two reasons, other students did not make fun of Maddie. Sometimes when Peggy was asking Wanda those questions in that mocking polite voice, Maddie felt embarrassed and studied the marbles in the palm of her hand, rolling them around and saying nothing herself. Now what is the meaning of embarrassed? Ashamed. So whenever Peggy used to ask silly questions or funny questions to Wanda, Maddie did not like this. And she used to play with the marbles which were in her hand, and she appeared like she was not at all paying attention to the questions of the Peggy, because she did not like that Peggy should torture or make fun of Wanda. Not that she felt sorry for Wanda exactly. She was not very sympathetic, or she was not feeling sorry for Wanda, but just like she did not like those questions. She would never have paid any attention to Wanda if Peggy hadn't invented the dresses game. Now all these game was being planned by Peggy. So because of this dress game, asking questions regarding dresses, so because of this dress game only, Maddie started paying attention to Wanda. Otherwise, earlier she had never paid attention to Wanda because her best friend was Peggy. But suppose Peggy and all the others started in on her next. Now the question was that Maddie was also poor. She was wearing the clothes of Peggy. Maybe Peggy did not like those clothes, or the size of clothes were not suitable for Peggy. So Peggy used to give her clothes to Maddie to wear. So she was thinking in her mind that if I will object Peggy that why she is making fun of Wanda, then maybe Peggy will also start making fun of me, and she will tell to everyone that this girl is also wearing my dresses and she is also poor like Wanda. So the thought of making fun of myself in front of others, that thought stopped Maddie to prevent Peggy from making fun of Wanda. She wasn't as poor as Wanda, perhaps, but she was poor. Now if we compare Wanda and Maddie, then Wanda was more poor as compared to Maddie. Of course, she would have more sense than to say she had 100 dresses. Still, she would not like for them to begin on her. She wished Peggy would stop teasing Wanda Petronsky. Now, Maddie thought that if Peggy would have asked me that how many dresses you have, then I would not have replied lie. I would not have told lie, just like Wanda had told. Now, because of this lie only, Peggy became very angry and she decided that now continuously or every day she would tease or she would make fun of Wanda. So Betty was thinking that if I had been in the place of Wanda, I would not have told the lie. Today, even though they had been late to school, Betty was glad she had not had to make fun of Wanda. Now, when they were late to school, okay? Now, when they were late to school, Betty was very happy that now Peggy would not get any chance to make fun of Wanda. She worked her arithmetic problems absent-mindedly. She was busy in solving the problems of arithmetic. 8 times 8, let's see. She wished she had the nerve to write Peggy a note because she knew she never would have the courage to speak right out to Peggy to say, "Hey Peg, let's stop asking Wanda how many dresses she has." So this questioning or this questionnaire of Peggy for Wanda was not liked by Maddie, and Maddie wanted to tell to Peggy that you should not make fun of Wanda. But Maddie did not have courage to speak directly to Peggy. So she decided that I will write a letter for Peggy in which I will write that you should stop teasing Wanda because she is also a girl. She is also a human being. Maybe she also feels bad for this. When she finished her arithmetic, she did start a note to Peggy. Now, after solving the sums, actually she was solving the sums of arithmetic, but her concentration was not on the sums. She was continuously thinking of Wanda and Peggy. So after completing the sums, she decided that she will now write a letter. Suddenly she paused and shuddered, but when she was about to start writing a letter, she stopped immediately. Some thought came in her mind. She pictured herself in the schoolyard, a new target for Peggy and the girls. Now Maddie thought that if I will tell Peggy that you should not make fun of Wanda, then Peggy will start making fun of me. Now I will be her next target. Till now, the target of Peggy is Wanda. Now, if I speak or if I say something in favor of Wanda, then Peggy will make me as a target and she will make fun of me or she will mock at me in front of all other students. Peggy might ask her where she got the dress that she had on, and Maddie would have to say it was one of Peggy's old ones that Maddie's mother had tried to disguise with new trimmings, so no one in room 13 would recognize it. Now Peggy and Maddie, they were very best friends. They were good friends. They shared the feelings with each other. And because of this friendship, Peggy never disclosed to anyone that Maddie used to wear my clothes. Now Maddie was thinking that if I will take favor of Wanda, then Peggy will become angry and maybe she will make me her next target, and maybe she will tell or she will disclose the fact to all of the students that Maddie is also poor and the clothes which she wear are not of hers, they are of mine. Means they are used, they are not new, they are old. If only Peggy would decide of her own accord to stop having fun with Wanda. Now the only solution is that Peggy herself should realize that I should not make fun of Wanda. Maddie decided that now she would not interfere in between the matter of Peggy and Wanda, because she thought that if I will interfere in between, then Peggy would make me as a target. Oh well, Maddie ran her hand through her short blonde hair as though to push the uncomfortable thoughts away. Now all these thoughts, they were going in her mind. So to remove those thoughts, those bad thoughts, She put her hand, she moved her hand in her hair. What difference did it make? Slowly Mary tore into bits the note she had started. Now maybe 1, 2, 3 lines she must have written, and after starting writing the note, she immediately stopped and she decided that no, I will not write any note. She was Peggy's best friend, and Peggy was the best liked girl in the whole room. Now Peggy and Mary, they were very good friends. It is a different thing, or it's a different matter, that Mary was having some soft corner for Wanda. But for this soft corner, she cannot scold Peggy because Peggy was her best friend. Peggy could not possibly do anything that was really wrong, she thought. Mary very well knew that Peggy is a good girl, though she always makes fun of Wanda, but basically internally she is quite good, and she will not do anything bad or wrong that will hurt Wanda. As for Wanda, she was just some girl who lived up on Bogens Heinz and stood alone in the school yard. Now, for Wanda, who was she? She was a girl who belonged to a poor family, to a poor background, and she used to live on Bogens Heights. She scarcely even said anything to anybody. In the school, she did not have any friend. Nobody was ready to share the feelings with her. Only they used to make fun of her. The only time she talked was in the schoolyard about her 100 dresses. Now, whenever she used to talk to her friends, she only talked about her 100 dresses, and that also for a limited amount of time. Maddie remembered her telling about one of her dresses, pale blue with colored trimmings. Now, whenever she used to give the description of her dresses, about her 100 dresses, she used to tell about the color also, about the design also. So Maddie remembered that one day she told that she was having a pale blue colored dress. And she remembered another that was brilliant jungle green with a rat sash. Another color also she remembered that she had described of her dress. "You would look like a Christmas tree in that," the girls had said in the pretended admiration. Now, when Wanda was discussing or describing about those 100 dresses, some children told that this particular dress would suit you too much, and when you will wear this dress, you will look like a Christmas tree. Thinking about Wanda and her 100 dresses all lined up in the closet, Maddie began to wonder who was going to win the drawing and coloring contest. Contest means competition. Now, on one hand, the thoughts were going on in the mind of Maddie that the thoughts were related to Wanda and about the 100 dresses which she told that she had kept in her cupboard. At the same time, the thought moved on towards the competition. The competition was related or concerned to the drawing and coloring. So Maddie was thinking that who is going to be the winner in this competition. For girls, this contest consisted of designing dresses, and for boys of designing motorboats. Now girls and boys, they both have participated in the competition and the contest of drawing and coloring, and the girls, they were supposed to make the designs of dresses, and boys were supposed to make the designs of motorboats. Probably Peggy would win the girls' medal. Peggy drew better than anyone else in the room. Now Maddie thought that Peggy is the best artist, and maybe she is going to win the medal, because there is no other artist just like Peggy. This all thoughts were coming in the mind of Maddie. At least that is what everybody thought. Not only Maddie, but all other students of the same class or of the same school, they also thought that Peggy is going to win the competition. She could copy a picture in a magazine or some film star's head so that you could almost tell who it was. Now, she was expert in copying the picture or drawing of anything. And when she used to copy the picture or drawing of any particular person or of any particular thing, it was very difficult to recognize that it was natural or man-made. Oh, Maddie was sure Peggy would win. So 100% Maddie thought that Peggy is going to win the competition. Well, tomorrow the teacher was going to announce the winners, then they would know. So they had only one day left for the result to come out, and Maddie thought that I am very excited to know about the result and I am waiting for tomorrow when our teacher will announce the results of the competition. The next day it was drizzling. Drizzling means slowly raining. Maddie and Peggy hurried to school under Peggy's umbrella. Now they were best friends, so they used to go to school together, and they also used to return back from school to home together. So as it was raining, Maddie and Peggy, they were moving under one umbrella, and that umbrella was of Peggy. Naturally, on a day like this, they didn't wait for Vanda Petronsky on the corner of Oliver Street, the street that far away under the railroad tracks and up the hill led to Bergen's Heights. Now it was their routine of Maddie and Peggy that on the way while walking towards the school, they used to wait for Vanda just to make fun of her. But today they were so excited to know about the result of the competition that they did not wait for Vanda to make fun of her. Anyway, they weren't taking chances on being late today because today was very important. So they thought that if we would wait for Vanda, we would be late because we don't know when Vanda will come. And if we would be late, it will be our loss because today the teacher is going to announce the winners of the competition. Do you think Miss Messon will announce the winners today? Asked Peggy. So Peggy asked to Maddie that the teacher has told that she is going to announce the result. But do you think that she will really announce the result? Oh, I hope so. The minute we get in, said Maddie, of course you will win, Peg. And Maddie was also saying to Peggy, she was encouraging Peggy that of course you are going to win the competition. So you don't worry about it. You will be the winner. And I am 100% sure. Hope so, said Peggy eagerly. So Peggy also told that I also hope, I also expect that I will be the winner in the drawing and coloring competition. The minute they entered the classroom, they stopped short and gasped. Gasped means they were very surprised. When they entered in the class, they were surprised. What they saw? There were drawings all over the room on every ledge and windowsill, dazzling colors and brilliant lavish designs, all drawn on the great sheets of wrapping paper. Now all over the room, even on the windows, on all the four walls of the classroom, there were beautiful drawings, and all those drawings were filled with various types of designs as well as various types of beautiful colors. There must have been 100 of them all lined up. Peggy and Maddie, when they saw the drawings, they thought that these drawings must be up to 100. Counting should be up to 100. These must be the drawings for the contest. Maybe somebody has made these drawings for the competition. Everybody stopped and whistled or murmured admiringly. Means not only the teachers, but also the students were praising too much for the drawings. They also liked very much because the drawings were so attractive and so alluring. As soon as the class had assembled, Miss Messon announced the winners. Now when all the students of the class, they gathered together, so Miss Messon, the teacher, the name of the teacher is Miss Messon. So she decided that now it's time to announce the names of the winners, that who has won the competition. Jack Peggles had won for the boys, she said, and his design for an outboard motor was on exhibition in room 12 along with the sketches by all the other boys. Boys and girls both have participated, and in the boys, Jack Peggles won the competition because he has made a very beautiful design of the overboard, and that design was kept in room number 12 along with the other drawings of the other boys. As for the girls, she said, although just one or two sketches were submitted by most, one girl at room number 13 should be proud of her. This one girl actually drew 100 designs, all different and all beautiful. So teacher told that all the girls whosoever were present in room number 13, all the students of room number 13 have submitted only one or two or at the most three designs. But there is one girl and everybody whosoever is studying in room number 13 should be proud of that girl, because that girl has submitted me 100 designs. And all these 100 designs, they are different. Not a single design is matching with another design, or it is similar to some other design, and all the designs are beautifully covered with, colored with colors. In the opinion of the judges, any one of the drawings is worthy of winning the prize. And all the drawings, the judges think that all these drawings, all these 100 drawings are worthy to win the prize, means they are excellent. I am very happy to say that Wanda Petronsky is the winner of the girls medal. So finally, Miss Mason announced the name of the winner, and the name of the winner was Wanda Petronsky. Unfortunately, Wanda has been absent from school for some days and is not here to receive the applause that is due to her. Means, since many days Wanda is absent, she is not coming to school, and today also she is absent. She is not present to take the award or to take the appreciation. Let us hope she will be back tomorrow. Now I hope, as a teacher, I hope that maybe she will come tomorrow to the school. Now class, you may file around the room quietly and look at her exquisite drawings. So teacher told that now that when I have announced the winner of the competition, and the winner of the competition is Wanda Petronsky, so now you can go all around the room and you can look or see at her designs. The children burst into applause, and even the boys were glad to have a chance to stamp on the floor, put their fingers in their mouths and whistle, though they were not interested to dresses. So boys were not at all interested in the designs of the dresses, but those designs, they were so beautiful, so attractive, so alluring, that even the boys, they moved all around the room to look to the designs of Wanda Petronsky. "Look back," whispered Maddie. "There is that blue one she told us about. Isn't it beautiful?" So Maddie told to Peggy that, "See, this is the same dress which was described by Wanda in her description. And I think that this dress is the most beautiful." "Yes," said Peggy, "and here is that green one, boy, and I thought I could draw." So the green one and the blue one description of the dress which she had given to Peggy and other students, those dresses were also present in the exhibition. It means when she told that I have 100 dresses, in one way she was not telling the lie, because in reality she was not having those 100 dresses in her cupboard at her home all lined up, but those dresses were present in her drawings which she herself had made. So these 100 dresses, she referred to these drawings. This is all about the chapter. In the next video, I'll come up with the second part of the same chapter, the 100 dresses part 2. Thank you.